If you have been following my videos, you know how important it is to use the correct texture maps to create realistic images. You already know that you have to always use the gloss map in the alpha channel of the normal map, and with some texture sites, you even have to invert the green channel of the normal map to have the correct lighting. This can become a tiring process doing all manually. That's why I'm going to show you a simple solution to speed up your workflow. Hey, what's up guys? Nunu here. So in today's video, I'll show you how you can speed up your texture creation workflow to create your materials in Lumion. And if you stick around, I'll show you how you can get the Photoshop Action preset for free. So let's get started. So in today's video, I'm going to show you a quick way to speed up the texture creation workflow. So, and also I'll show you why you should invert the green channel as well in some textures, like for example Megascans or the polygon ones as well. So I went to Quixel Bridge. Here you can browse all the Megascans, and I'm gonna get some metal. So I got this one, corrugated metal sheet 2x2. You just click and download. You have here the albedo, the gloss and normal map. Okay, this is the most important textures. You also have the displacement. If you have Lumion 10.3 and above, you can have your own displacement map. And so if I go to, just copy this, if I go to Lumion, I have here this scene that I set up just for this purpose. And I'm gonna load up the material, I mean my texture, and I'm gonna load the albedo. By the way, some people ask me about albedo, or sometimes they just have albedo or they just have diffuse. So the albedo and diffuse are basically the same. It's just that albedo doesn't have the shadow in the texture map itself. But you can use here in the color map, you can use both, either the albedo or the diffuse. Now I'm going to load up the normal map, and this will be the normal map that I set up already with the, it's not this one, sorry. This normal map, it's set up with a gloss map on the alpha channel. And this one is not with the green channel inverted. Okay, so I'm gonna take a test render so we can see how this looks. Okay, now before I speak anything about this, let me just show you the one with the inverted green channel. So it's this one. Okay, now I'm going to take a new render. Okay, now I'm just going to load this into Photoshop just to be easier to compare. Okay, like this. So you see, this is the one without, let me actually, without the green inverted. Okay. And this one is with the green inverted. So you can see the difference here, especially on this area here. So the shadow here is much more defined, as you can see. So this part goes up a little bit, and then you have here the shadow. But actually, let me just do like this on this area here. Okay, let's see. This area here. So if I, you see the difference in the shadow here? So that's why it's important to have the green channel inverted in textures that come from Megascans or from Polygon, and even from other sites. But you just have to test it like I did here. You just create a sample scene like this. Just put a light like this, and you can easily tell immediately if the light is working correctly on your material. And if they are, you just need to test with one texture from that specific site, because all the others will be the same. Now let me show you the main purpose of this video.
So sometimes when you have a lot of textures that you want to create a lot of materials for Lumion, you have to all the time import both the gloss and the normal map to make the gloss map in the alpha channel of the normal map, so you have the correct reflections, the correct lighting on your texture. And if you do this all one by one, it can become a little bit boring doing it for every texture. So I'm going to show you how you can speed up this process. So inside Photoshop, you have here, first you open both textures, the gloss and the normal map. Then you go to Window and you have your Actions. Open up, it will open this here, this window. And then you can just press here on this plus button. And I'm going to call this my action one. You can set up a shortcut for this action to be loaded. So let's put F6, or actually F7, Shift Control. Okay, Shift Control plus F7 will trigger this action. So let's play record. And now everything that we're going to start doing here, it will be recording. So first thing you want to do, green channel. I'm going to press Control I. I inverted the map. Now I'm going to here, I'm going to press Control A and Control C to copy this texture. And now I'm going to here on the bottom, I'm going to create an alpha channel. I'm going to press Control V. I'm going to press here again and I'm going to stop this action. Okay, now this is my action, and you can see this with Shift Control F7. Now let me just close this one again, and I'm going to load up this texture again just to show you how it's working. So now I just need to press Control Shift F7. So you see it inverted the green, and it also adds the gloss map on the alpha channel of the normal map. So now you can just save this map, and you don't need to do all of this copy pasting and inverting. So you just need to press this one shortcut, and that's it. And there's also another thing that you need to do in Lumion. For example, when you want to add, let's say, an opacity mask or a mask for emissive material as well, you can do this in the albedo map. So to do this, let me just open here. We will create another action. So let's press here. Let's call it my action 2. In this case, I'm going to put the F8, Shift Control, record. And for this one, I'm simply going to the opacity mask, I'm going to Control A and Control C to copy. And then I'm going here and create alpha channel, Control V, click here back, and stop the action. And so this way, if you press Control Shift F8, if you are creating, for example, in this case, some leaves, some vegetation assets, you just need to press this shortcut and it will be creating for you this. So this is the way to create these actions, but I already created this myself, and I'll share with you the file. So I'll leave a link in the top right corner and in the description below this video. And by the way, I have a Lumion course in which I teach you how to create high quality and realistic renders in Lumion, and with the shortest render time. I'll leave a link to it in the top right corner and in the description below this video.
That's it for today. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to give me a thumb up, subscribe, and click the bell button to get notified when I publish new videos. See you in the next ones.